Helix.
Attracting today's new post-traditional learners means adopting new enrollment strategies. Helix Education's data-driven, enterprise-wide approach to enrollment growth is uniquely helping colleges and universities thrive in this new education landscape. And Helix has just published the second edition of their enrollment growth playbook with 50% brand new content on how institutions can solve today's most pressing enrollment growth challenges. Download it today for free at helixeducation.com/playbook.
You're listening to Enrollment Growth University from Helix Education, the best professional development podcast for higher education leaders looking to grow enrollment at their college or university. Whether you're looking for fresh enrollment growth techniques and strategies or tools and resources, you've come to the right place. Let's get into the show.
Welcome back to Enrollment Growth University. I'm Eric Olson, AVP of Marketing at Helix Education, and we're here today with Lesley Nichols, Executive Director of Professional Studies at Emerson College. Lesley, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you, Eric.
We're going to have a great conversation today about how Emerson was able to take their professional and continuing ed department and fully integrate it into the rest of the college and the awesome results that move has had. But before we get into that, Lesley, can you give the listeners a little bit better understanding of both Emerson College and your role there?
Sure. So for those of you who are not familiar, Emerson College is a small private liberal arts institution located in the heart of Boston, Massachusetts. We are really known for communication and the arts. So it's a liberal arts school that combines communication in really innovative and creative ways. We're probably best known for our film program, which was actually just named one of the top 10 in the country just a couple of days ago, which is fantastic.
Congrats.
Also known for our journalism program, our writing programs, performing arts, everything from musical theater to acting, our political communications program. Last year during the elections, you may have heard our polling society on television trying to predict some of those results.
Sure.
We have just under 5,000 students for our enrollment. The majority of those are undergraduate, but one of our big initiatives is trying to grow our graduate population. So my role in professional studies at Emerson is really to help integrate what we would call professional or continuing education for working professionals, adult learners, integrating that better with the rest of the college's academic programs. So everything from graduate certificates and graduate degrees, all the way through the student life cycle, even serving high school students with our pre-college programs, which serve as a pipeline into the undergrad programs at Emerson.
Awesome. I'm so excited to talk about this because I think adult and continuing ed departments are often outliers on campus. They often have separate governance, often with separate resources. Talk about the benefits of integrating these continuing ed departments into the rest of the college.
I think there are so many benefits to doing so. And throughout my career, I've worked in continuing ed probably over half of the time I've spent in higher ed. And as you said, they definitely tend to be the outliers or the stepchildren, as some people say, of the main campus. But one of the things that I found really exciting at Emerson with the initiative to try and bring professional studies more into the fold is this notion of being able to work with a much broader audience and diversify the audiences at Emerson. You know, so much of our population now is no longer the traditional residential, 18-year-old to 22-year-old student. That still exists, but we're seeing more and more people, even of that age range, who have full-time jobs. You know, they're juggling work and school, and they really need some more flexibility in how they attend college. So I see this as a really great way to bring in adults of all ages into the fold, bringing with them a variety of work experiences, opinions, culture, different age ranges. It just brings so much diversity to the classroom and also opens up brand new audiences for the college to serve.
Your president and provost were critical to making this integration happen at Emerson, including the hiring of your position. Why do you think it was such a priority for them, given Emerson student breakdown at the time. And why is it so important for senior leaders to buy into this concept of bringing adult education into the fold?
Well, I think there's a couple of reasons. As I mentioned, you know, Emerson's traditional population has been comprised primarily of undergraduate students. We do have graduate programs, but over the years, you know, we've seen some decline in graduate enrollment. And a lot of that, I think, is around how our population has changed and trying to adapt to the times. So adults are looking for something much more flexible that will fit their lifestyle. And I think, you know, through some market research that the college had performed, they found very quickly that one very interesting fact about Emerson was, even for our graduate programs, the audience that we were attracting is much younger than the industry standard. So typically, you know, most colleges and universities will see a graduate population comprised primarily of, you know, individuals who maybe have been out of school for a few years, they earn their bachelor's, they have some work experience, and then they come back for their master's. But here at Emerson, they were finding that the bulk of their graduate population was straight out of their undergraduate degrees. So there was definitely an opportunity from an audience perspective that we were missing a lot of adults who were, you know, above the age of 30.
Yeah.
And especially in a market like Boston, which is incredibly crowded, you know, I can't even count the number of colleges and universities we have here. But Emerson definitely has a very unique value proposition in the type of programming that we offer and the type of hands-on training that we provide. So I think they saw a market opportunity, and that was one thing. But I think also another facet was trying to grow online programs. And in most universities that I've seen, the professional or continuing education unit tends to be kind of an innovator in that area and trying to bring in new technologies, new ways of delivering programming. So I think that's probably the crux of why they really wanted to have this partnership. But I think as we build it, we'll see even more benefits along the way.
Let's say you're able to get executive support at your college or institution. Now let's talk about how to do this when so much current infrastructure today is set up and organized around the traditional student. Where did you start at Emerson with this integration?
So now we're getting to the hard part.
Yeah.
Actually implementing. You know, I think some of the challenges, especially in this day and age, is that we're in a 24/7 society. So any student, any customer expects 24/7 service. And yet colleges across the nation, even across the world, are really set up on a different model, you know, where we have the Monday through Friday, you know, 8-to-5 type of business model. So I think, you know, some of the first stages in trying to make this a reality were on the technology side. So trying to provide some solutions that enable students to have more of a self-service experience so that they have certain things they need to accomplish off hours when a staff member may not be here to assist them. We're not preventing them from doing so. We're trying to enable them. So that's everything from being able to register and pay for their classes, you know, from being able to put in a request for a transcript, maybe for IT help service after hours. So the technology, I think, is probably the first area where we started, and we still have a lot of work to do in that area. And then the other area, I think, is really more the support. Everything from student advising to student accounts and the registrar, you know, how can we better integrate those services for adult learners, but also make those in a way that it's convenient for someone who may have, you know, a day job and they can't necessarily get advised during the day, but, you know, could we provide some services for them on the weekends or after hours?
That's awesome. And one benefit that you talked about offline that I'd love you to chat about is talk about the ROI benefits of shared resources and marketing spend when promoting your programs together with the rest of the college versus off on an island or even a separate department doing its own thing.
Yeah, there's so many benefits, and I feel like things are just coming together so nicely. Emerson's currently undergoing a complete brand revamping, and one of the areas that we're working on is a complete website overhaul. And the exciting thing about that is I think everyone is on the same page about trying to help prospective students find what they're looking for. So let's just say someone is interested in a screenwriting program. You know, they may not know in advance if they want a graduate degree, maybe they just want a certificate, or maybe they even want one course. You know, as we're set up right now, they really have to kind of dig through the website to try and find all of these different options. But part of the new branding initiative will be combining these resources so that someone who's looking for that topic could come to the website and immediately see all the variety of options they would have within that field. So that's kind of one exciting area that I feel will really benefit all of the programs at Emerson. Also from the marketing ROI standpoint, as we are spending money to promote, you know, our new graduate certificates, we can promote those alongside graduate degrees. So, you know, we're not spending extra money and resources from a staffing perspective or from an advertising perspective to advertise similar programs to possibly similar audiences and spending double the money.
It's an awesome reminder to let's give the student as seamless of an experience as they can without having them be whimed to our internal organization or lack thereof. Really good reminder. Yeah. Finally, can you share some of the early successes you've seen so far with your continuing ed department being fully integrated with the rest of the college?
Well, I will say it's still a work in progress, sure. But along the way, I think probably one of our most exciting initiatives is the launch of our first graduate certificate, which will be in entrepreneurship, and that launches this January. Already, we have over 200 inquiries, so there's definitely some interest out there. It's also primarily an online program, so that's something that kind of fits in with our mission of growing online and providing more flexible options. And graduate certificates we really see as a growth area for the college, and professional studies is really serving as the intermediary. So we're working with the academic departments to develop, launch, implement these programs. And we have really strong partnerships that we've built with our enrollment management team and admissions, with the marketing team, with advising, to really make this a seamless experience. So I think that should be one of our early successes. And we have several other grad certificates in the pipeline getting ready to launch next year. I think the other exciting thing is our pre-college program, which is a high school program of academic enrichment in the summer that ties in directly with Emerson's undergraduate degrees. And that is serving as a really successful pipeline to bring new students into Emerson as undergraduates. We've seen a lot of success over the past year in integrating our application system for pre-college with the undergraduate and graduate admission system. So all of the students then are using, you know, the same resources, the same process, the same systems to be able to enroll. And we're able to then sort of use this CRM to create a full life cycle for a student all the way from high school through possibly a graduate degree if they stay with Emerson long enough. So I'm excited about that possibility and really growing that over time.
Awesome. Really, really exciting stuff. Lesley, thank you so much for joining us today, sharing all the great things you're doing at Emerson, and really being an inspiration and aspiration for all of us who want to have a more integrated structure at our college and universities. What's the best place for listeners to connect with you if they have any follow-up questions?
Oh, I'd welcome any listeners to connect with me either on Twitter. My handle is Lesley, A, my middle initial, _Nichols. They can also connect with me via email. My email address is Lesley_Nichols@emerson.edu.
Awesome. Thanks so much for joining us today, Lesley.
Thank you, Eric. I appreciate it.
You've been listening to Enrollment Growth University from Helix Education. To ensure that you never miss an episode, subscribe to the show on iTunes or your favorite podcast player. Thank you so much for listening. Until next time.